God, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we come and celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask God for his mercy and forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you call us out of the darkness of sin into the light of life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood for our sake and for our salvation. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who desired the Virgin Saint Kateri, Tekakwitha to flower among Native Americans in a life of innocence, grant through her intercession that when all are gathered into your church from every nation, tribe, and tongue, they may magnify you in a single canticle of praise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The way of the just is smooth, the path of the just is made level. Yes, for your way and your judgments, O Lord, we look to you. Your name and your title are the desire of our souls. My soul yearns for you in the night. Yes, my spirit within me keeps vigil for you. When your judgment dawns upon the earth, the world's inhabitants learn justice. O Lord, you mete out peace to us, for it is you who have accomplished all we have done. O Lord, oppressed by your punishment, we cried out in anguish under your chastising. As a woman about to give birth rises and cries out in her pains, so were we in your presence, O Lord. We received and writhed in pain, we conceived and writhed in pain, giving birth to wind. Salvation we have not achieved for the earth. The inhabitants of the world cannot bring it forth. But your dead shall live, their corpses shall rise. Awake and sing, you who lie in dust, for your dew is a dew of light, and the land of shades gives birth. The word of the Lord. From heaven the Lord looks down on the earth. You, O Lord, abide forever, and your name through all generations. You will arise and have mercy on Zion, for it is time to pity her. For her stones are dear to your servants, and her dust moves them to pity. The nations shall revere your name, O Lord, and all the kings of the earth your glory. When the Lord has revealed Zion and appeared in his glory, when he has regarded the prayer of the destitute and not despised their prayer.
From heaven the Lord looks down.
Let this be written for the generations to come, and let his future creatures praise the Lord. The Lord looked down from his holy height, from heaven he beheld the earth, to hear the groaning of the prisoners, to release those doomed to die.
From heaven the Lord looks down on the earth.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest, says the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said, come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So my second parish assignment was at this little church in church in a Bolivia. It was in the middle of these great cornfields and fields that was run by the Amish people. I was completely surrounded by fields of crops, and the Amish people will be driving up and down the road in their buggies and so on. And we had a beautiful statue of St. Kateri, and I learned all about the history of her, that she was born in the 1680s up in upstate New York, the same place where I was born. I was born in Albany, New York. And she lived such a very difficult life. She lost her parents, her family, her entire family at the age of 4 when a smallpox epidemic broke out up in the upstate New York area. And she had to be raised by an uncle that did not believe in Christianity, did not believe in the Catholic faith. And she was very disfigured. She was half blind as a result of the smallpox. But she became very devoted to her faith. And at the age of 11, pledged her life to a virginity and chastity to serve the Lord. And when it became apparent that she couldn't live out her faith in and amongst her uncle and so on, she walked 200 miles to go to this other reservation where the Jesuit priests were having a stronghold, and how they were preaching the good news to the Iroquois Indians and so on. So she left the Mohawks and went to the Iroquois Indians in that part of the country. And she was always found carrying a Bible. She always carried a Bible in one hand and a cross in the other. She would walk around the fields in and amongst this reservation and pray constantly. She was constantly in prayer, but then she would tend to the sick, she would tend to the needs and follow the orders of the Jesuits and so on. And she died at a very early age because of her ailments and so on. But she was canonized by Pope Benedict XVI a few years ago. And why? Well, because of all her ailments and because of all the things that she struggled with, she still prayed and she still served. And to me, she's an inspiration that when I'm not feeling the greatest, or I might be tired or so on, if she can do it, then I need to do it. I can't use excuses not to love and to pray and to serve. She was, like I said, very handicapped as a result of the smallpox, but it never deterred her from bringing Christ to others and to pray. Let's let her inspire us that when we feel a little down, we feel a little tired, not feeling the greatest, that we can still bring Christ to others and to unite our suffering like she did to Christ on the cross. And in this way, we can truly serve the Lord and others like she did.
Thank you. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Heavenly Father, we thank you for hearing and answering our prayers according to your will and not ours, so that we may grow closer to you in mind, body, and soul. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bless us, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, fruit of the earth, the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise to his disciples,
proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. And remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ and all the dead, whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, especially Saint Kateri, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. And through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
So now the Savior's command, let us pray the prayer our Lord Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
And Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
The peace of Christ.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the words, and my soul shall be healed.
Behold, the bridegroom is coming. Come out to meet Christ the Lord.